Hello everyone and welcome back to Immersive Gameplay Builds. This time we are at Nordhagen Beach and we're going to finally see what's here. I had a little problem figuring out what exactly it was this was going to be because unlike Sunshine and Starlight, this one didn't really lend itself towards a buttoned up, bunkered up thing because he's allied with the Brotherhood of Steel and as you can see, the Pridwin's in the background. So he's not gonna have any problems with defense. If he has to, he'll just, you know, whistle and have a bunch of guys in power armor run across the bay and help him out. So this thing was, I mean, it went through like, I don't know, 6 or 7 different iterations here. And this is the final result. It basically turns out to be like a little vacation home, I guess, a resort or whatever. But you can see the original building in there. Yeah, before I start, this is just immersive gameplay. The only settlement mod I'm using is OCD, like normal. And as usual, I did not scrap much of anything to try and give it that whole raggedy look. So we'll take it one at a time. So the main building's there. And then on the right, I forgot to close the door, is the weapons workshop. And in here, we've got his arch and the usual, you know, built it up around the workbench, used it as the centerpiece and just kind of plunked this stuff in around it. But it's his usual, you know, regular supplies for, you know, doing weapons and stuff like that. And his toolbox, his beer, and his arch kind of jammed in that wall. It works. So close the door here. And then he does have a dog with, you know, some extra dog food and teddy bear and his dog dish and yada, yada, yada. But this is the side of the building from here. We'll go around it after this. I'll show you the outside of the thing, what it looks like from the outside. Then the main entrance, of course, is the typical standard courtyard that I like. I didn't move the chem station because it was already outside, so I was like, well, that's perfect. I'll just keep that the way it is. So go in here, and we've got his cooking station. You know, like I said, there's not really much stuff here. He doesn't, like, live here. This is a place where he can get stuff done, but it's not as self-contained and, you know, hugely defensive as the other two were because of course, the Pridwin and the Brotherhood. In the first room, we've got his power armor station, the primary power armor workstation. There's a storage one in the back. We'll go in there in a second. But his normal stuff, a big crate full of fusion cores, because why not? And the tool chest there holds all the pieces that he has. Immersive Gameplay has this suit as soon as you go into the Institute, this thing's sitting in father's room. So I was like, all right, I'll just take it. Works for me. And then his living quarters, well, here's the old entrance to the house. I took the door off because, of course, I got a door there now on the right, so there's no reason for it. But all the comforts of home, lots of guns, vegetable soup, some food, some coffee, magazines for entertainment, and then the sleeping, resting, lounging area, armor's underneath the bed, clothes are in the dresser here on the right, and just, you know, the regular stuff he's going to need when he hangs out here. Toiletries and the distress beacon, because I figured, you know, that's his panic button, right? So if he gets under attack, he just hit the button and the Brotherhood will come running, theoretically. But it's good in headcanon. It's good in my head. It works, right? So that's all that really matters. Well, that's all I like to tell myself. Added a bunch of those plants from the outside, give it a little more lived-in look. Here it is from the other side. I chose to keep the exposed wires because in this application, it seemed to work better. It just makes more sense to have exposed wires here. Even though there's sand, and it'd be easy to bury him, the sand to move around. So here's the original field. Picket fenced it, walled it off. Got the generator, one of those little hutches that I like. With, you know, repair stuff and more beer. Toilets outside, because I had actually built this toilet before I started putting them indoors. Which is a good thing, because I don't think there'd be any room inside this thing for the toilet. So here's the side of it. And of course you can see the roof line there, where it's sort of sticking out. Then in here we've got his administrative area. I'll turn the light on because it's kind of dim in here, even in the daytime. Well, you know what? I'll turn it back off so you can see what the light looks like. Shelves full of snacks and supplies and books and reference materials and tchotchkes everywhere. And it's got a terminal here. The terminal is because I actually used a dinnerville light for the first time ever. We'll see that one go back outside. But this is his working area. Pretty standard. And then there's Dance's armor with every piece of legendary armor that Tegan sells, so I've got it on here. With polishing equipment and liquids and fluids and, you know, the other random crap he couldn't store inside, so that works. Then, so we look at the outside here, and you know, another cobbled together. These little outbuildings are only like one floor piece apiece. So there's not that. And there's the interval light right there. That'll show up better at night. That's his warning light for low-flying vertebrates. I figured I'd give him a little warning on not to hit the power lines when they're coming back to the Pridwin. So that light cycles, and we'll see that in a second. So he's got a little thing on the beach, finally built something on the beach. His raggedy-ass pathway here with, you know, driftwood and pallets or whatever the hell else he could find to cobble together. This turret doesn't really get a lot of action. It's just here to give him an audible warning if he's out here fishing and somebody attacks. This thing will go off and he'll know it's out here. But here's his little pier, his little chilling area with fishing poles and fish on the rack and beer in a bucket, more ammunition just in case. And then, of course, the radio, which I turned off because I don't want copyright strikes. And a little grill with some stuff in progress. And you know, like I said, just random crap scattered all over. We'll see what this thing looks like here from the end of the pier. So that's the whole thing. That's his little, I don't know what the hell to call it, dock. So we'll go back up here. And then around the back, we've got this. I basically just took a settlement beacon and sunk it so you couldn't see the switch. It's not hooked up to nothing. But this is his way of signaling the Pridwin because I like to do this. Yep, that dish points right at the front end of the Pridwin. No reason whatsoever other than it makes me feel better. So there's the light up there and the outside of the weapons workshop with more plants. Big junk pile here. And that is about it. That's the whole thing. That's his resort home. That's his home away from home, I guess you could say. And of course, the shadows are on the wrong side. And what I did this time is I'm going to go ahead and build my, I'm going to go ahead and put the warehouse thing back up here. Put the ladder back up here because I didn't want it sticking out. I wanted to get have a nice little profile of it as you walked up to it without this big thing sticking out looking all distracting. So put this up here. And click that. Come on, straighten up. Do that. Jump over here so the thing goes off. There we go. And up we go. And then we'll do the nighttime tour in just a moment. So here it is. Go. There's the whole Nordhagen. Oh, there's my provisioner. All in white armor so I don't shoot him by mistake. And there's his homestead. So let me go switch to nighttime and I will be right back. And here we are at night. It's, you know, my usual, if you've seen my lighting before, you'll know what this is. It's basically very sort of dim. I mean, this is not as dim as the other ones are because, of course, it's on a beach and it's going to be well lit no matter what. But it's all, you know, spotlighting and accent lighting and stuff like that. Nothing really, nothing too obvious, too bright. My usual trick of putting the light behind the pillar so when you can't really see it from this direction, but it lights everything up nice. But this is enough light for him to work in at night. It's got enough stuff for him to do his thing. And of course the dog's out here. The dog's in a really good position because when they get attacked, they usually come over the front and he doesn't have any problem at all bolting out of his little doghouse and just running right at him. So here's the front of it. Again, with, you know, the usual lanterns on posts and the candles in the ashtray. But yeah, I think this came out kind of nice. I do like the way this came out. It did take a little more work than I was anticipating because I kept changing direction on it. You know, it just didn't. Every time I come back to it, I'm like, this is almost right. This is almost perfect. This is almost, but something's wrong. I don't know what it is. I don't know what's wrong with it. And it turns out what was wrong with it was the concept. I was still, you know, banging my head against the thought of making this a whole enclosed thing. When in the back of my head, I kind of knew it didn't make sense since the Pridwin was right there. So then it eventually turned out looking like this, blah, blah, blah. So got the field, a little pathway down here, and, you know, got the turret, some random lights. He doesn't really do much work on this at night, so I didn't really put a light out here. I was thinking about putting a light, you know, one of those lamps out here, but it didn't work. It just didn't work. That's the problem. It's administrative area, using again those track lights that I like so much because I can focus the light exactly where I want it. His stuff here is nice. He's got institute plants and restored fans and, you know, undamaged cigarettes because he stole them all from from the Institute because, hey, they're good for supplies if nothing else. And, you know, the power armor station. This building was kind of fun to put together because I sort of had to wedge it against the back of this because I had built this part first. And as you can see, the roof's kind of hanging over and these things are sort of, you know, cobbled together there. But it played pretty good in the sand here. And the raggedy pathway kind of looks like this. Doesn't have, you know, consistent railings, doesn't have anything else. Got a little, you know, barrel here so he knows where to turn when he's out here at night. And then, of course, his night fishing. You can't disturb whatever kind of mutant fish are living in here with light, so. But yeah, you know, fishing poles leaning up everywhere. Just, this is the kind of stuff he would use, I would think. I mean, he wouldn't really need a lot of stuff. So we'll go back up here. And then we'll look at my signal beacon. I love this thing. It took a couple of tries to figure out how to make it flash to where it looked like an actual signal beacon. So if you try to make one of these yourself and you like the way this thing cycles, it's 4 seconds on, 2 seconds off. That's how I was doing 3 and 1, 3 and 2, 3 and 3, you know, whatever. And 5 seconds was too long to have it lit. But that seems to be the right heartbeat, I guess, for this sort of thing. Anyway, going to go back around the front. And that, well, let me get stuck on the truck here. One of the downsides of not scrapping stuff is you run into them. So here we are, folks. Here is Nordhagen Beach. This one's in the can. And after this, I think I may be going back to the Microbuild. I took some advice from y'all and downloaded Ethereon's vanilla extensions with the main one that you have. And I really like it. There's some things missing that I wish I still had, but I'm going to experiment with it. We'll see what we can do. But it might be the end of USO. I don't know. Anyway, I want to thank you all very much for subscribing and watching. And I will see you in the next one. Take care.